The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey everybody, this is Attilio, and this is the part of the show where we do, what do we do at this part? Adrian, remind me.
Attilio's Random Thoughts.
Yep,
it's Attilio's
Random Thoughts.
The art part of the show.
Tell you how boring I am. I got a puzzle from the store, 2,000 pieces. It's huge. A lot of pieces. And what are the, you know, and it's an analogy for life. Are there more than 2,000 pieces in the day-to-day, week-to-week, month-to-month, year-to-year of our lives?
Yes.
Yeah, way more than 2,000 pieces. So if we think about this puzzle and we're like, wow, this is just, it's overwhelming. There's too many pieces. How am I going to ever put this thing back together? Kind of like your life. How are you going to put it back together or keep it going or maintain it or improve it? And the first step, same thing in life as with the puzzle. You got to open up the box. So you got to step into life. Get up. Get out of your bed. Open up the box. And then the next thing you're going to do is you're going to need to have what? You just get up and just randomly do stuff?
No, you got to have a plan.
You got to have a plan. So when you open up, those of you who do puzzles, you cool people like me, what's the first step? Well, you got to put all the pieces in a big pile.
Mm-hmm.
The first step is what?
To look for patterns.
No, the first step is to flip all the pieces over. There's going to be a pattern. Half of the pieces all mix up and upside down. You don't even know what you're looking at. And so you're going to flip all the pieces over, spread them out, and then what's the next step?
Then you look for the end pieces.
You look for the end pieces or the edge pieces.
The edge.
Because they're a puzzle piece where one side has a straight edge.
Mm-hmm.
First thing in the morning, you're just going to roll out of bed, fall on the ground, and like, I don't know what I'm going to do. Or the straight edge that you're going to be looking for the pieces is get your butt out of bed, drink some water. There's a straight edge. Go work out.
Brush your teeth also.
Brush your teeth for your gym mates. Mm-hmm. They was telling me the other day you were going to the gym without brushing your teeth. And they're like, oh, horrors, brah. Brush your teeth. Unless you're in the treadmill behind me, then I just gonna run faster. Oh, wait, I'm not going anywhere. I still smell your. Woo! Anyway, brush your teeth. Those are the straight edges of life. You got to look for those pieces because there's like a million things we can do in a day. Or can we start off with the straight edge pieces, which makes the frame for your day or the calendar for your day, the schedule, that's the frame of the puzzle. And then once you get that frame up, which is your daily schedule, then you start putting all the other pieces where they do. And so with the puzzle, you got to have a guide. So the guide is, are you just randomly looking at every piece and seeing if it'll fit? Or is there a picture on the box?
There's a picture on the box.
The picture on the box for
reference.
Your life.
Yes.
Podcasts. There's a picture on your on the box for your life. Webinars, therapists, coaches, people who have success or are in life where you want to be. That's the picture on the box. And you
books.
Just got to look at it.
Books. Yep.
You know, speaking of books, I'm going to segue. I don't believe you read a book if you listen to it. Because what part of your eyeballs and words and text on pieces of paper or even on a Kindle are you using to read when you're listening to it? So people
I think you can do the audio and read at the same time.
That I will tell you right now, though.
Listen and read at the same time.
And listening to a book is not a substitute for reading.
Mm-mm. But you can listen to it while reading to help.
Yeah, if you're bipolar. No, it's buy the actual copy of the book, read it, take notes, because there's a difference between reading to read and reading to learn.
Mm-hmm. That's taking notes.
You don't read to learn listening to an audiobook. Those people are like, oh, how many books you read this year? I read like 22 books. You mean you listen to 22 books? Yes. There's a difference.
You listen.
Speaking of someone
reading.
That cracks the book open on Allstate Insurance and reads that book, takes notes, and knows a lot about it, who are we talking about, Adrian?
That would be Bradley Mariama from Allstate Insurance.
Bradley.
Are you there?
Are you there?
Which good
you
afternoon. For us?
Good afternoon.
Okay. So there's a lot of, like we spoke the other day at lunch, there's a lot of associations that are increasing deductibles on the master policy.
No way.
And so when that occurs, the insurers have to call us up and say, hey, Brad and team, I have to increase my dwelling or building coverage up to the minimum of the deductible. So if the deductible is $25,000, we have to at least reach that mandatory coverage for the association. In turn, we have to send proof of insurance to the association so they know that the insured has the required minimum. Now, when you call our office and you're letting us know, Brad, I got to increase my building coverage up to $25,000, we're going to say, hey, Adrian and Attilio, did you ever do any upgrades to your unit? You know, a lot of people think $25,000 is enough, but if you redid your kitchen and redid your flooring over and above the base grade of that condominium, a lot of times it's going to be worth more than $25,000 to replace if there was ever a fire or really bad water damage. So although the minimum requirement is $25,000, sometimes we'll recommend people after doing an assessment that they might need $35,000, $40,000 in coverage, only because if there ever is a fire, our agency wants to make sure that that kitchen can be rebuilt and there's nothing coming out of pocket. Because we don't want you guys to be that one insured that does go through that unfortunate fire. There's not enough coverage. You have to come out of pocket, and you're going to be like, oh, Brad, that's the guy that didn't give me enough coverage. He didn't even offer it to me, so I didn't know that we could have done this. So, you know, do the reviews. Make sure that even if the requirement's $25,000, do an assessment with your agent to make sure that if you do have upgraded kitchens, countertops, and flooring, go over and above that recommended, that minimum coverage.
Adrian, you had a question.
Yeah, so Bradley, when speaking with your clients and assessing the replacement cost, do you ever have them do like a video walkthrough or pictures so you can kind of help them gauge what that cost today would be? Because maybe they did these upgrades 20 years ago and it cost a certain amount then, but now, you know, things have obviously changed.
Yeah.
It's changed, and, you know, sometimes they'll do FaceTime. Sometimes, believe it or not, a lot of people still want to see me face-to-face, so I'll go to the condo.
Oh, wow.
A lot of these people are actually saying, I just did an upgrade, and you're right. It cost me $38,000 to redo my kitchen and my floors. So a lot of times I'll have them send me that that invoice, and then we'll stick it in their file. And then we'll say, well, you know, we'll increase that coverage to $35,000, $40,000, because you got to understand, if there is a fire, there's going to be demolition.
Yeah.
There's going to be water remediation. So it's not just the cost to redo that kitchen. There's going to be other costs associated with rebuilding that kitchen.
Well, I love to hear that you make the home visits and you'll go face to face and just confirm.
You know, you would think some of the older folks, they don't want to drive or can't drive.
Yeah.
But they actually don't mind me coming into their house. So, you know, it is an option when you're dealing with our agency.
and you're the, don't mean to put you on the spot, but you got the vaccination for the COVID?
Yep, I got the vaccination and booster. So if someone did want to check out my credentials, I'm boosted and vaccinated.
Yeah, you know, I got the vaccination the other week, and also I also got a tick collar. anyway, so in addition to my booster, so I don't have any fleas or anything when I come to your house.
That's
so
good.
Guaranteed. Yeah. So that's a great advice, Bradley.
Going above and beyond for the clients, as usual.
Well, I'm seeing, we're seeing a lot of that with the insurance, with the association for the condos. Are you seeing it with the homeowners association or mostly the condos, the high rise, the townhomes condos?
It's majority with the condominiums, but we have seen 10,000 deductibles go up to 25, even with the townhomes and the townhome association. So it's all across the board. And I think, again, what they're trying to do is just limit the exposure to the association to keep costs down on the maintenance fee. So it is somewhat a benefit to the homeowner, but yet they're actually putting a lot of the onus on the homeowner's insurance carrier or their personal insurance.
Okay. Well, thanks, Bradley.
Yes, always excellent information. Thank you, Bradley.
And
so you can get a hold of Bradley by going to our website, teamlally.com, under the resource tab and experts we trust. There's actually a video there and information about Bradley and his team.
Well, you know, if you want to see how we put the show together, you can actually watch us record. You can watch us live streaming
on Wednesdays,
doing the show on Wednesdays on all of our platforms. What is it? YouTube, LinkedIn,
Facebook, Twitter. Yes,
it's on Twitter.
It's on Twitter.
Oh man, Twitter! I don't even know what that is. That's like it's like you have a you have an itch or something you can't get to. Is that what a Twitter is?
No.
It's a rare species of bird.
No, so, I mean there is a little bird on the logo.
But anyway, if you're watching us on the live stream, you're seeing where I'm going, teamlally.com. I'm going to the resources dropdown, hitting the experts we trust. If you're a realtor new in the business, you're not sure what professionals to work with, hey, tell them Team Lally sent you. You can go to our resource page, dropdown experts we trust. You know, I wanted to, before we get the next guest on, talk about, you know, is now a good time to be selling your home? The market's kind of crazy. What is my home worth? How would you answer that question, Adrian?
Well,
a good time to sell?
I would say first, let's have a conversation.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we want to, with our team, like we want to take a consultative approach and take a look at the big picture.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, it's a great time to sell, but taking a look at your particular situation, it may not be.
Yeah.
So,
well,
I would say it depends.
Well, it depends. You mean like the adult diaper?
That's right.
Yeah. Just we like should get that. Them as a sponsor. Anyway, not for me personally.
not yet.
But anyway, yeah, no, I mean, I'm excited. I'm in the best shape of my life. And in a couple of months, on my birthday, I'm going to turn 55 and I can go McDonald's and get 10% off my cup of coffee and hang out with all the grandpas and drink coffee at the McDonald's. But one kind of weird thing, though, I don't drink coffee. So maybe I'm going to talk story with them, arm wrestle. Hey, list your house with me if I beat you arm wrestling.
Okay, so back to is now a good time to sell?
Well, you're asking the questions. Well,
yes.
Let's say I need to sell whatever. I'm PCSing. What does that mean, Adrian?
Permanent change of duty station.
And how do you know that?
I was in the military.
You were in the military?
Yes, that's how I got here.
Oh, man. What happened?
I got out and decided to do real estate.
Oh, okay.
And
good.
I stayed.
Yeah.
Been here 20 years.
So we understand the military family's process of buying and selling, PCSing, and we understand all the acronyms.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you got a PCS, job relocation, we've seen people that want to upsize, downsize. I don't know what other situations. People just, unfortunately, maybe you're in the travel industry or the tourism industry and you just can't bounce back and get caught up with those mortgage payments.
Or maybe you're getting a divorce.
Yeah.
Lost a job. I mean, there's a lot of reasons why, you know, people need to sell.
Let's say you're locked and loaded and I have to sell and you give us a call. We're going to make sure that we understand completely and go into depth on your why.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're going to take you through the process. Is now a good time to sell? And you know what? If you have to or want to, if there's some compelling reason. We've even talked with a couple the other day. They bought the home not even that long ago, and they've seen quite a bit of a jump.
Yes.
And what was their plan?
So there's this little thing called capital gains taxes.
Yeah.
And if you live in the home 2 of the last 5 years.
By the way, we're not CPAs giving tax advice. Verify that with the tax professional.
So if you live in the home 2 of the last 5 years of your primary residence, then you get the homeowner exemption from those capital gains. So I guess it's like mid-April, they hit that 2-year mark.
Yeah.
So we're strategizing with them to go on the market and then close escrow by that date.
After the 2-year anniversary of their home. So there's no capital gains, no taxes.
And they've made quite a good return.
A couple hundred thousand. So, and they're going to go move on base.
Yeah.
They even said it like that. Hey, we're going to move on base because we want to take advantage of all the equity in our home now.
Yes.
So, hey, sounds like a plan. Speaking of someone that's got a plan.
We've got Ryan with Zero Res Hawaii.
Yeah.
Ryan, what do you have for us today?
Regarding cleaning.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Great.
Good to hear from you guys.
Yeah.
So, actually, I just wanted to, as far as an update goes, we had a really cool experience today where we got into this home where we see a lot of people who love their pets and love having them inside. But one inevitable thing that we've just seen again and again, not only is the pet stains a lot of the time, but even if you get them properly trained, the hair that just gets in the carpet, whether you realize it or not. You know, I wish I could show pictures to everybody listening, but what happens is we come in with these counter-rotating brushes, and it pulls everything up to the surface.
Yeah.
And just seeing all just the clumps and everything that come up, it's a lot of people are like, oh, my gosh, they're so embarrassed, right? And we're just so used to it because it is a very typical thing. Like, I can tell 100% who has had a pet in their home or not. Even homes that have had pets in the past and their current residents do not, you can tell. So that's just one thing that I've seen that I would recommend for anybody who has a pet. Just get in there and care of you.
Yeah, get you guys involved.
Yeah.
So, Ryan, how really often, nice yeah, with the pet owners, how often should they be having this service done to keep up with the all of the shedding and the hairs everywhere?
Well, it depends.
If it's a really big problem or it's been a long time since you've had any treatment at all, then I would recommend maybe like once or twice in the first year. But after that, yearly should do the job. You know.
So have an annual treatment. And this is like a special one just for pets, or this is for any?
So that's the cool thing is a lot. We do have a pet extraction charge that we would charge if it's a specific stain.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But what you've seen with a lot of the darker carpets, you can't necessarily see the stain, but you can smell it. We had one of those today where we went in and she was just bothered with the smell. And just our regular treatment process, we'll get the smell and all of the...
You know, and that, Ryan, that's important to know because, like, there are people that are not pet people. And I would say pet people and not pet people, it's a terrible analogy, but I'm going there. It's like smokers and non-smokers. If you're a non-smoker, you can smell smoke. We got into a lift up in California. I was ready to puke. I mean, it wasn't pet smell. It was just the smoke. And I was like, and we were in the thing for an hour.
I think you're just way more sensitive.
I don't know. I came out of there smelling like an ashtray. And I was like, I told Adrian, I said, leave a review for this person that his Hyundai smells like an ashtray. I didn't know Hyundai, the car manufacturer, actually made ashtrays on four wheels, but there is one driving around in California.
So look out.
An ashtray. So
same
it's
thing
important.
With the pet smells.
It's going to help with the sale of your home if people can walk in. Because one of the things we tell people is in preparing your home, you need to eliminate the
visuals.
Any signs of pets.
But then there's the smell, and that's when Zero Res comes in to help with that smell or any kind of stains that still smell.
And just that overall, like, things left behind, right, that you don't necessarily catch with the naked eye, but they affect the quality of your carpet or your furniture. Another example that we saw this week was somebody who wanted to get their sofa cleaned. It was pretty new. They'd had a professional clean before, but they're about to sell it.
Yeah.
So we went in, and there were, like, you could see, you know, those marks, like kind of like dirty, soily areas.
Yes,
and
the
we
traffic
went in
areas,
and
yeah.
Our hand tool is transparent, so you can see the water coming out of it. And it was so soapy. And we don't use soaps or shampoos for our cleaning process. So seeing all that soap come out of that cushion was crazy. Our client was just blown away at how much soap the previous person who professionally cleaned that couch had left in their couch.
Yeah.
And that's exactly why it got so dirty and so stained, is because that soap was still in there. So that was another
attracting
thing.
The dirt.
You just don't touch it. Like, sometimes people are just upset. Like, I don't think I'm that dirty, but if there's anything left behind, any pet stains, any soaps, I think it's a lot dirtier than it ever would otherwise.
Yeah.
Well, I can speak from experience and also as a pet owner that Zero Res has come in and they cleaned a couch for me. They got my travertine floors cleaner than they've ever been, maybe since they've been installed, and got through the grout lines and everything, and even did a little treatment on my granite countertops to remove some of that hard water stains. So you guys have a lot of different resources and tools to, mm-hmm. you know, just keep the home clean and maintained. So very happy yep. with your guys' services.
Yeah, we appreciate that. Thank you.
Yep. Well, Ryan, thank you for calling in. Excellent tips as usual. And we'll let you get back to your cleaning.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day, guys.
Thank you. Okay, again, that's Ryan with Zero Res Hawaii. You can find them under the resource tab and experts we trust. Next up, we have Chastity with American Floor and Home with her tip of the week.
Chastity. Hi, guys.
Hello. What do you have for us this week?
Yes, what you got for us?
Okay, so the exciting news for this week is that we have clients who come in. They love the feel of engineered hardwood, but they want something waterproof. Hmm. So we have waterproof hardwood flooring. It's basically a hybrid of a small veneer of hardwood on the very top and luxury vinyl core. So a lot of them that we have in store here is going to have a stone core. So it's going to have the veneer in the top, stone core, and it's a click and lock. So very easy to install too. So you don't have to worry about all of that humbug of trying to maintain your engineered hardwood flooring anymore.
So yeah. Chastity, with the pricing of that, how does that price out versus like the hardwood that's like the traditional hardwood versus, I guess, just the regular laminates?
So it falls right in the middle. So mm-hmm. installation cost is going to be the same as if we're doing it like a luxury vinyl flooring, because it's a click and lock floating floor. Mm-hmm. So that already is less in cost versus installing an engineered hardwood. And then the veneer is very low, small in comparison to an engineered hardwood. So that already cuts the cost in comparison to your traditional engineered hardwood. So let's just say, for instance, if you're paying $13 a square foot for engineered hardwood, you'll be paying about $7 for a waterproof hardwood floor.
Wow.
Ooh, waterproof. We like that. And yes. I like that click yes. and lock, because
it's easy.
You know, like, you should ask the installer, were you good with Legos as a child? And they're going to say, yes. Okay, now yes. I'm doing Legos for adults. It's called click and lock flooring.
That's right.
And
exactly.
And but be careful. They might, you know, make a Death Star on your floor.
Oh, Chastity, I have a question. So you guys, it's American yeah. Floor and Home, right? We talked about some flooring. Do you have yes. other supplies like mirrors, light fixtures, stuff like that to, you know, fill in the rest of the home?
Yeah. And Adrian's favorite, area rugs.
I know they have area rugs.
Yes, that we do have.
We talked about that before.
And you are her dealer.
Yes. We would love to supply everything, but we do not at this time have light fixtures or other types of like fans or ceiling fans, that kind of stuff. But we are able to help you choose and pick and put you into the right direction and where to go. We have expanded just to like countertops, your bathroom fixtures, like mm-hmm. your faucets, your handle poles, but we haven't gotten the finishing touches part yet.
Yeah.
it sounds like it's on the way.
Well, I
coming
mean,
yeah, soon. One day will
coming
be.
Soon. I think you guys have yes. a lot of things on the list, and people's expectation. Oh, it's kind of like when you watch the Domino's commercial. Oh, you can get a pizza for $9.99, except Hawaii and Alaska. But with you guys, we can at least order it. But it's pretty cool that you guys have you guys have the biggest warehouse.
That it's
most
just
stuff
here.
On the roof.
Yeah, you don't have to wait.
Yeah, don't have to wait. So a lot of stuff might be in stock, and then maybe you got to order some yes. stuff. But I think people are already used to that. So if you have most yes. of it, they'll be like pleasantly surprised.
That's right. So.
At least I can get started on my project.
Yeah, and just, you know, in Hawaii, that's we used to that already, but it's good. You guys are a locally owned employee-owned
yes.
company.
Yeah.
So even the
very
guy
proud.
Sweeping the parking lot, you like, I like talk to the Absolutely. Manager, and he's gonna be like, you got him. I want to talk
that's
to the
right.
owner.
I'm an
the
owner.
Yeah. I'm an owner.
Yes,
so
everyone.
That's
yeah.
good, because it
We're
provides.
Really proud of that.
Yeah, it provides. Everybody's in, right? Nobody's like, I don't think you guys have people walking around going, that's not my job. Sorry, it's not your job. You're the owner.
Yeah.
Everything is your job.
Yeah. So we all wear different hats in this company.
Yeah.
We're all this and that. We all help each other out wherever we need to pull together. That we're very we're very proud that this is our company.
Yeah,
and hats, we see it every single day.
Hats off to the family that and the founders for doing that, because that says a lot about them and them wanting to pay it forward to the employees that helped them have this local company that's been around for so long. So good job on that.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Chastity.
So
yep.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.
Okay, so that's Chastity with American Floor and Home. You can find them, again, on the resource page under Experts We Trust. Well, we are going to take a short break and stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking to Chad Shimabukuro, team leader at Keller Williams Honolulu. We'll talk about what makes Keller Williams so unique and profitable for real estate agents.
So stay with us.
Hey, it's Tina Hollyfield with the Royal Ride on Country 97.5. And I love extra money, but I don't want the drama that comes with it. That's why I always recommend Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams Honolulu to any of my friends needing to sell their home. Just like my friends Nolan and Doherty, they told me they wanted to move to Las Vegas. Well, who doesn't, right? But they had to sell their home first and fast. Team Lally was able to build up such a large demand, starting with the grand open house, that they ended up getting 6 offers their first week on the market and sold for $20,000 above asking price. If you're wanting to move and need to sell your home, even if you're not going to go to Las Vegas, call Adrian and Attilio at 808-799-9596. That's 808-799-9596, or visit TeamLally.com to schedule an appointment today and tell them Dita sent you.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it.
Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Hello, Hawaii. It's Colin Cowherd. Things may have changed in the sports world, but the games must go on. Look, I invest in real estate all over America, and right now, with the ultra-low interest rates everywhere, if you're serious about selling your home, you need to talk to my friends, Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally, real estate group of Keller Williams Honolulu. Team Lally's incredible marketing with 3D tours and its huge database of buyers has continued to sell homes quickly with multiple offers over the asking price. Adrian and Attilio continue to spend tens of thousands per month on marketing to attract hundreds of buyers every month using a unique app that communicates daily with over 3 million luxury home buyers around the United States. Adrian and Antilio guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it themselves. Give Adrian and Antilio a call at 799-9596 or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And start packing.
Hey, Buck, as a real estate investor, if you were going to buy or sell property in Hawaii, what's the first thing you'd do?
That's an easy call. Call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. They've always guaranteed to sell your home or they will buy it. I love that confidence and the marketing that backs it up.
You aren't alone. Sean Hannity, Colin Cowherd, Scotty B., and Barbara Corcoran from Shark Tank all agree with us. Team Lally are the agents we trust, and that trust is well-founded. They're selling homes for up to $70,000. Over asking, what would you do with an extra $70,000?
How much time do you have? I mean, I've got a long list. Do yourself a favor. Check out all the reviews and see why thousands trust Team Lally. Google Team Lally, or if you want immediate answers, give them a call at 799-9596.
And don't forget to check out the Team Lally Real Estate Show right here every Saturday morning at 10. Get the best advice from Team Lally.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues. Give it to me, I'm worth it.
Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Our guest today was born and raised on Oahu, attended college in California, and resided in Arizona. He is a licensed mortgage banker in multiple states and a real estate broker in California, Arizona, and Hawaii.
He is currently the team leader and principal broker at Keller Williams Honolulu and is one of Hawaii's top 100 realtors for the past few years. Please welcome our guest, Chad Shimabukuro.
Welcome, Chad.
Yes, welcome.
Hi, guys.
Hello. So, we got to clear the air. Are you related to Jake? And can you play a ukulele?
No. You know what's funny is people ask me that question in town. Are you related to Jake? On the west side, they say, are you related to Miley?
Yeah.
So that goes to show like what where that question is originated. No, but I'm not related to either.
Either. Shimabukuro is Japanese for Smith.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right. That's exactly right.
All righty. So, Adrian, go ahead.
So, Chad, this is the first time we've had you on the show. So, welcome. We're very excited to have
you.
And I know we had our intro, but let's talk story a little bit about, you know, first, what high school did you graduate from?
I always like to joke and say I went to, this is really for Attilio, but I went to Kamehameha Lower Campus, which is Farrington High School. I actually went to McKinley and then graduated from Farrington. And I grew up in the Kalihi area.
You know, even though I graduated from Kamehameha, I did go to Farrington because every day for lunch, I would go to the Taco Bell down there in Kalihi. Burrito Supreme. I'll get the Burrito Supreme and then make our way back up. They don't let the kids off campus anymore. So no more exchange student program at Taco Bell in Kalihi for the Kamehameha school.
That's right.
Yeah. So born and raised here, but then you left and somehow got involved in this real estate industry, but you had quite the journey.
Yes.
Tell us your path of travel.
Yeah.
Well, the short version of it is I left after high school, went to Southern California, attended college there, and, you know, trying to find my way. I really thought I was going to be in the medical field and be a doctor and was pursuing that path.
Yeah.
I ended up leaving, didn't finish that, and thought I was going to change course and go to law school and didn't finish that either and was trying to just find my way. And kind of it's a testament to how unbelievable the real estate industry is. And I had friends that were doing mortgages and real estate, and they kept saying, you know, forget what you're doing there. Come over to what we're doing. It's really fun. It's unbelievable. And so forth. This was probably around 98, 99, mm-hmm. around that time. And I finally made the jump and got into the industry in 2000. And I've
Y2K,
been here.
Y2K, I remember so, that. You know, Y2K, you remember? The whole world, all the computers
the was world
gonna
was
blow
gonna
up.
End.
The whole world was coming
world
to
was
an end. Prince was doing his final That's concert, right. party like it's 1999.
And Chad was getting into real estate and mortgages.
I remember I was living That's in right. Arizona, it was wintertime. I bought a lot of firewood.
Really?
Yeah.
You know what I was doing? I was bartending.
You know
I was just partying.
You know what they was doing on Oahu? Just completely buying out all the bottled water and toilet paper.
Oh, yes.
Hawaii people, we love to buy the bottled water and toilet paper when anything started. Oh, the UH Warriors, they lost the whole season. Buy bottled water and toilet paper. We got to buy out the store.
Okay, so back to Chad 49, and his
49
journey.
49 is lost. Buy
toilet paper and water.
So you've been in the industry about 22 years and have had experiences with different brokerages and brands and roles. Maybe share a little bit of that part of your journey.
Sure. And, you know, what's interesting is it's funny how life goes and how our industry and the availability in our industry, not only the opportunity to get into our industry, but the different things that you can do within it. And especially KW, and I can talk to that in a little bit too. But I've been an independent agent. I've had my own teams. I've ran other people's teams, or what we would refer to as mega teams. And I've kind of floated around and done different things. And I love that experience, not only on the real estate side, but also the mortgage side too. Having that mortgage background has only made me a better real estate agent because there's a lot of transactions that I may have saved as a result of knowing the finance part of it, or what issues may arise when I'm representing a seller
yes.
and the type of offer that's being sent over. I can kind of look at it and immediately see you know, that's not going to work for a variety of different reasons.
Gotcha.
Now you're taking all of this knowledge and experience and you're sharing it and now training and teaching the KW Honolulu agents. So tell us about this training that's available for the agents.
The difference between coaching and training.
Yeah. Yep.
Sure. Yeah. And I'll tell you this much too, is I never thought that I would be in this role or position or anything like that. It was really, some of it is you guys, some of it is Colette Ching, who was one of the owners of KW Honolulu, and other people that kind of encouraged me to take this role. But my why is I love helping other agents, whether they're new or experienced, and pouring into them. And basically, I feel as though I treat it as though the industry has given me so much in terms of opportunity and money and income and homes and all these other things. I owe it to our industry to pour back and to create better agents. And I think the difference in KW and other firms is there's such a high failure rate in our industry that we want to set people up for success. And so we offer training, coaching, mentorship, education. They sound like the same thing. They're really different things. And we have the whole gambit of that really allows someone to succeed at a high level. And let me just say this one thing, which is interesting and might resonate with some agents that are maybe new or kind of lost and trying to figure things out, or someone who's even deciding to make a switch out of their existing job, is NAR, National Association of Realtors, did a survey a few years ago, and they surveyed hundreds of thousands of agents across the United States, across all brokerages. And they had asked them, without having another transaction, how many months could you survive with what you have in savings? And myself being super conservative, I thought the answer was going to be like 6 months or a year or whatever it is. The answer was 1 month. And interestingly, the takeaway that I had is, you know, people get into our industry and say, I'm leaving my salary job or my hourly job because I want to be my own boss. I want to break through that glass ceiling. I want to, I don't want anyone to put restrictions on my income and what I can earn. But what they did was they went from transaction to transaction, or they went from paycheck to paycheck to transaction to transaction. And one of the things that we teach is mindset and how to look at things as a business and have a business within a business. So it's completely different than any kind of training or education that you would get at other brokerages. Ours is, in fact, we're the number one training and education company as well. So
yeah, and this is from really independent sources, not just us saying it, you know, training magazine.
Yeah, don't take my word for it.
Yeah,
absolutely.
You know, don't take his word for it. Take my word for it. We are
take Google's word for it.
Take Google's word for it.
Google it. You'll see.
But that's critical what you're saying, because, you know, it's NAR, the updated statistics, you know, is 1 month, except if Canes had 2-for-1 coupons, then it was 2 months that they could last with the coupons for the three-finger chicken special. I have a joke for you guys. If you go to Canes, ask them, what if you said, can I get the middle finger special? I said, do people come and ask for that? Because, you know, I got the three finger, I got the four finger.
It's the middle.
The middle. Maybe if they upset. Only if they upset.
They send you out with the condiments.
Yeah. No chicken for you. So, you know, you're providing more of a, like a full spectrum type of, you know, it's almost like life coaching too, because, you know, you think about it, mindset. Is that like, oh, we just use that for real estate and then I go home and yell at my significant other and beat my kids? Or do we take that growth and that mindset and be a better whoever we are back at home?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So personal and business is interconnected.
Yeah. You know, the profit sharing. Let's go talk about that. What is that profit sharing?
One of the unique things, KW is known for a good handful of very unique things that other companies don't offer, one of which is something called profit share. And Gary Keller, the founder of Keller Williams, who's kind of like the Steve Jobs in real estate, he created profit share to basically allow real estate agents who's part of KW to feel as though they have ownership and stake in the company. And they do. So if we're profitable in a given month, half of those profits go directly back to the agents that help bring in the agents that made us profitable to begin with. And at a very high level, there are agents that are earning well over $1 million a year on just the profit share. And by the way, that's passive income. And we teach things, that the difference between active income and passive income. Active income is what you got to do every single day. You got to get up and shower and dress and go do something to earn money, whereas passive income is the true trajectory to wealth. Because if you can do this passive income model on a higher scale, you don't even have to leave your house or get out of bed. This thing is now making money for you. And so this is a passive income tool. And it's not required. It's just there as a tool that Gary Keller created for the agent's benefit so that they can grow their wealth, which is amazing.
Now, Chad, this profit sharing, does it go away like after you retire? Or how does that
work? Or if we don't like you.
Yeah.
If you don't like me, I might cut you off.
Yeah.
But no, I'm just kidding. It's actually vested. So you can retire with it. You can will it to charity or a spouse or your children. Or, yeah, so it's an actual income-generating tool. And it goes on forever. It grows forever. So even if you retired, it is absolutely possible and very likely that your this profit share and passive income will continue to grow and get larger and larger, especially as the company grows. Guys, we have almost 200,000 agents worldwide, which is completely crazy.
The largest,
about.
And right?
We're the largest on the planet.
Largest
in the world, and we're expected to have a huge growth spurt because Keller Williams just announced that we're creating a real estate school.
Oh.
And that school, our mission for that school is zero tuition.
Wow. So I'm glad that you mentioned that because I know that we're kind of getting a little bit of a kickstart here in Hawaii. And we have one coming up is in March, right? A free school.
That's exactly right. So
free school,
so no tuition
at
all.
Did you say free?
Free.
How much was that again?
Free school.
Free.
Zero.
It's free preschool for real estate.
60 hours. It's a 60-hour course.
Well, that's pre-licensing, right?
On
you call
Zoom.
It free preschool. That, you know what? That's my marketing thing. I just gave it to you guys. Free preschool for real estate.
The pre-licensing.
Thank you. We'll use it.
We get you a bologna sandwich. We're going to cut off the crust.
So, Chad, to put this into perspective, typically a school like this, what are people paying to attend?
Yeah, I've seen a couple hundred dollars.
So an instructor-led school. This one is constructor-led. So instructor-led means that there's an actual instructor teaching throughout the course where it's via Zoom. So you can attend from your comfort of your
home.
COVID safe. If you have questions, you can ask those questions directly to instructor. And anywhere between $800 to $1,200 is what you would pay to another real estate school for similar instructor-led course.
Yeah. And you don't have to be like telling your boss, oh, I got to go smoke break. I'll be right back. Because you can just do it.
So,
where you went? He was gone for 60 hours.
So we are having a career night on Monday.
Yeah.
And we'll be talking more about this free school. And if any of our listeners want to learn more, if they can't attend the career night, just send us an email to info@teamlally.com. And we will give you everything that you need to know about the free real estate course coming up.
And to register for the career night, just go to HawaiiCareerNight.com. If you cannot spell that, then we don't want to talk to you. You can spell Hawaii and career and .com.
So, and we might even see Chad Shima. He may pop on.
May pop on.
For hello.
Yeah.
That would be great.
Absolutely.
So Chad, if we could get some success stories, examples of agents who have come to be a part of our company that are newer or seasoned and use the resources and tools, could you just share some of those?
Yeah, absolutely. Let me just set the premise by saying that KW is unlike any other real estate firm or brokerage or platform or model. It's completely different. It's totally different. And we teach you how to be not only a better real estate agent, but a better business owner. So we allow you to have a business within our business.
Yes.
And also how to be a better person. There's so many classes and training for that specifically. But as an example, if ever one were to look at the top agents in any market, whether ours or in the mainland or whatever, you'll notice that there are far more agents in the top percentile of productive and income-earning agents, and there's a reason for that. Keller Williams allows you to be as profitable. It's the model is for the agent to be as profitable, not the brokerage to be profitable as it would be with another firm.
Yeah.
And with that said, there's an agent that, without naming them, there's a perfect example. There's an agent who was a very successful agent, was producing about $8.5 million a year. He's a broker, came over as an independent agent. And by the way, $8.5 million a year is nothing to sneeze at. That's great production. Yeah. That's definitely already on a higher side of production. He's been with us now for about 6 years, and he's going to finish the year up upwards of $80 million.
Wow.
And he learned everything that he, you know, for his sake of his growth and production was as a result of the tools, models, the instruction, the coaching, everything that he implemented was from KW. So we launched you into a different stratosphere of doing business. So
I was in classes with him. He was a really good student, and I seriously mean that.
And it's, yeah. and it's paid off.
Yeah.
Completely.
Yeah.
Yep.
So be a good student and be in front of the right teachers.
That's right.
So
that's absolutely right.
Having the right attitude, you know, it's kind of like
the right mindset.
The right mindset and the attributes and stuff, like the Men in Black, you know, that one part where like, we are looking for the best of the best of the best. We're not recruiting for Men in Black, but there's three characteristics: humble, hungry, smart. Tell the people what, I mean, I think that's what you're looking for in a significant other, in your kids, every person
in
your life.
Just people you want to be around.
Yeah. Humble, hungry, smart. What does that mean?
Well, you know, I would love to add one more onto that, which is humble, hungry, smart, and growth-minded.
Yes.
And that's certainly something that we look for. And if you're an agent, by the way, we're not an open door company in that we take all comers. We're very culture oriented. So I kind of think of myself as the gatekeeper of our culture in our company. And those are the four qualities that we look for in an agent.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if you're brand new or if you've been doing this for 50 years at a very high level. If you don't possess those qualities of being humble, hungry, smart, and growth minded, might not be the right fit. But I can assure you that we will change your life for the positive. If you do possess that, we don't care about experience. We can teach you the rest.
And I know we've had seasoned agents, top producers that slipped under the wire, as we say, and they were signed off. What does that mean? Signed off? They were invited to leave.
I think part of the reasoning or like the way that we can do that is because we follow the capping model.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter if you do $100 million
we
a year.
Will cap you.
Yeah.
What is the capping model?
Yeah, explain that. How that works.
So I'll tell you, this is the best way to explain it is we are an equal opportunity, unequal results type of company. And what that means is if you're an agent that does $6 million in production or you're an agent that does $600 million in production, the brokerage makes exactly the same. We make exactly the same. So we're going to treat both people the same. At other brokerages, a lot of the complaints that I hear from agents that are making that switch and coming over to us is, oh, this producer is treated differently because they do X amount of business, but I do less, so I can't get the attention of my broker. I can't get some marketing. I can't get this. I can't get that. We treat everyone the same because we literally don't make more than a certain amount of money. And by the way, if you want more information on that, call me, and I'm happy to explain that to you and what that looks like.
Well, and we've experienced that firsthand because you've ever heard the phrase, you know, I was treated like a redheaded stepchild. Well, Adrienne has red hair. She is a stepchild, and you guys have treated her very well.
Thank you. So, Chad, what is the best number if anyone wants to learn more about what KW has to offer? How can they reach you?
You can call me directly on my cell phone. I am absolutely available to answer questions, whether you're thinking about getting into the industry or you just passed your pre-licensing or whether you're an experienced agent and want to have a confidential conversation about what that might look like. You can call me on my cell phone at 808-754-5800.
5800. 754-5800.
All right. So as we're wrapping things up, Chad, is there anything that we should have touched on that we haven't talked about yet?
Yes.
I would say the only thing I would say is there's so many things coming up with KW. There's something called Family Reunion that's coming up that's available virtually. It's physically going to be in Orlando. If someone is interested and you're an agent now, reach out to me and let me know. We can connect you with that. But to that point of Family Reunion and that it's a training conference. There's so much training available, much. So if you're an agent, whether, you know, we come from contribution, so there's no strings attached, no cost, no obligation. If you're interested in learning anything from us that you can apply, even in your existing business with your existing firm, we are happy to help. We're happy to pour in to you without the obligation of you coming over to us. But I guarantee once you start seeing what we do and what we have to offer and the culture that we have here, it's a little contagious and it's hard for people not to come over.
You know, we say family reunion, but it's not a whole bunch of people walking around with T-shirts that say, you know, the Kaneo Pio Ohana.
It says Keller Williams on it.
It says Keller Williams. It's the name of our annual convention that we have. And
because we think of each other as family.
We do.
We're a giant family.
And, you know, people like accuse us of, you know, well, if you go over there, you're going to have to drink the Kool-Aid. And I will tell people right now, we have upgraded to margaritas. No more Kool-Aid.
Top shelf margaritas.
Yeah. 1800 tequila. No. That's done right. On your own time. And I always tell the agents, when you go events and have some drinks, please don't end up in the bulletin. Anyway.
And don't post on social media.
Yeah. Did you know that? If we have a real estate magazine, if you get one DUI, you're
posting, on there.
You're in the bulletin. And everybody like, oh, I got the bulletin for the educational facts. Baloney. We all going to the back page to see who got one DUI.
That's awesome. We read it like Japanese style, back page.
Backwards. Yeah. Also got DUI. Oh, too bad. Anyway. No, we're just joking around. But we have fun. Mm-hmm. I think the key, you know, one of the things I like about our culture is there's no egos here. And ego stands for, you know, if you're a non-religious person.
Eliminating growth opportunity.
If you're a religious person.
Edging God out.
There you go.
Okay.
Two for one on that.
We got them both covered.
No ego. Everybody, you can ask anybody, hey, I need some help. Mm-hmm. I need some help. And people will help you because that... I mean, you said it earlier. I mean, typically our industry is you sign up and knock yourself out. We'll be here when you close something.
Yeah,
that's right.
But you guys are, you know, so much educational opportunities.
And that's why we're a part of Keller Williams.
Yeah. But quick reminder, yes. You still got to go out and help people buy and sell
that's
some
right.
homes and close some deals.
Yes. Don't get ready to get ready. You do your training, yeah. But you got to also do
well,
the
that's,
work.
We have this lady, she's like one stern auntie. She does productivity coaching and she kicks your cola if you're not doing your work, what you're supposed to do.
She is a stern auntie.
She's a stern
she
auntie.
She will get you into production, though.
Get you into production. No, we love her, Lisa.
Yeah, she's amazing.
She's the best.
Just like Chad.
All right, Chad. Well, we appreciate you so much being the team leader. You're kind of like the CEO, the big kahuna.
And the principal broker.
And principal broker.
Keeping us all out of trouble.
Yep.
Following all the rules, contract negotiations, all of that. Thank you.
Yeah, one last kudos for Chad, and I mean it seriously. He totally nerds out on the contracts,
mm-hmm.
All the technical aspects of real estate. If I was like on a debate team and real estate was the debate, I would have to have Chad would be the team captain.
Yes.
If I was
for
on,
sure.
If I was on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, he would be my phone a friend. If it was real estate.
I don't know how to take that, but I'm going to take it as a compliment.
It is.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, I would just put, I would pay to have you on the show and then split the proceeds with you because you would win. But thank you so much, Chad.
Thank you, Chad.
My pleasure.
All right.
My pleasure, guys. Thank you.
If you want to get a hold of Chad, the number, 745-5800. Again, that number is 754-5800. It's right on the screen. His email, chadshima@kw.com.
All right. Thanks for listening. And thank you to our sponsors.
Jody and Derek of Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley with Allstate Insurance.
Kenji with Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke with Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Robinson with Fine Line Paintworks.
James of Kaji Cleaning.
Chastity with American Floor and Home.
Jake with Skyta Construction Roofing and Solar.
Ryan with Zero Wares Hawaii. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We also want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Jee-hoo.
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price in our time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.